Alright guys, welcome back. This is going to be a refilming of the finale. And I just wanted to tell you guys that before you guys don't see an achievement at the end of this video. The reason being why it's a refilming is because I was interrupted.
Bullshit.
3 minutes in after playing this part. And the review, I think the review could have been a little better. So yeah. Finish this off.
Hey, unless you got news from the foundry team, I don't want to be disturbed.
Enemy operative in the vicinity!
Shut up.
I'm a watch in combat situation, asshole. I'm the definition of SP. I'm the most suspicious person you'll meet. Devin!
Stand down! Hold your lines! Don't let him near DW!
Get a job! He got
Devin!
All right, Weston, come here.
What do you mean all our operatives are dead?
Wait, hear me out! No more talking!
I swear to God, if I'm interrupted again by the same person, I'm gonna be pissed off.
Got Mr. Weston. Let's take him out of the city, make him disappear. Meet me on the cliffs off the GOH, Chilliad Mountain State Wilderness.
Not gonna happen.
This is why people want to kill you. You won't shut up.
Oh, God.
You're a resourceful guy getting past those crazy killers. I need someone like you in my organization.
The CEO position's gonna be vacant real soon, Slick.
I've got nothing against you, apart from the obvious hygiene issues. Michael called me Franklin, so Michael has to go!
You're looking at it rationally. There are people who are useful to you and people who ain't. And the people who ain't gotta go. Me? I'm not rational. I don't care if you're useful or not. I feel like taking you out, Devo.
Took the wrong turn.
What I'm doing.
This is a serious offer. Work for me, you'll have everything you ever wanted.
All I've ever wanted is to watch you drift in and out of consciousness as you're slowly disemboweled.
Yes, that's the kind of creativity I need on my team. Come on, let me out of here.
Look, I got my own company, Trevor Phillips Industries.
Oh, yeah, a fellow entrepreneur. Give me
you heard, but I'm kind of gold rich right now, so you got precisely nothing to offer. Prepare for the end, my friend.
You're dead!
Yeah, sure. I'm dead. Yeah.
Take the money! Let me go!
Go meditate, you phony prick!
Is he really in a position to make threats right now? Didn't want to do that. Alright, before we begin, let me put on the music because I'm pretty sure Rockstar has a good music for the credits.
My friend won't be happy if I empty a clip into the trunk. Here we are, Slick, with a few minutes for some one-on-one time.
Oh, that's lovely.
Hey, we good, T?
Never better, amigo. Franklin?
Ah, he'll be here.
What's up?
I assume you got him?
Ooh, safe and sound. Ain't that right, buddy?
Hey, my bad, homie. I picked C. Ain't that a bitch?
You know, Devin, the way I see it, and hey, I'm no intelligent businessman like you, but the way I see it, there's two great evils that bedevil American capitalism, the type that you practice. Number one is outsourcing. You paid a private company to do your dirty work for you. And then you underpaid that company because you thought you were big enough and bad enough that you didn't have to play by the rules. Oh, number two, offshoring your profits.
Offshoring?
Oh, it's horrible. You wouldn't want to be sent offshore just to save a little money, would you, T?
No,
Franklin?
I wouldn't. Oh, no, I ain't going nowhere.
No, see, but we know your opinions on the matter, Devin. Keep your problems the fuck out of America, huh?
In this instance, when he puts it like that, it makes sense.
Of course it does. Hey, Devin. Goodbye, my old friend. Thanks for all the advice.
Bye-bye.
Well, at least we don't have to hear from that prick anymore.
So now what?
Now we keep a low profile and get on with our lives.
As friends.
Well, do I have a choice?
No, not really.
All right, then. As flawed, awful, totally uncomfortable, and poorly matched friends. Absolutely.
Oh, that's perfect. Then we can get back to the kind of capitalism we practice.
Shit, I don't know how much more better that is than Devin's con.
Ooh, hypocrisy, Franklin. Civilization's greatest virtue.
Jesus, your therapist has a lot to answer for.
I know, I still hate myself. But hey, at least I know the words for it now.
Yeah, but I hate you, and I know the words for it. So does that mean I don't have to go to therapy?
Look, man, you two motherfuckers terrify me of that middle age. I'm good.
You're right to be afraid, Franklin.
Yeah.
Be very afraid, Franklin. Tell you one thing, T. I'm getting too old for this nonsense. Oh.
Alright guys, that's it for my Let's Play of Grand Theft Auto 5. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you guys enjoyed... Well, I hope you guys enjoyed playing Grand Theft Auto 5, because let's face it, half the population is pretty much playing this game, as it sold about a billion copies, I think, in just 3 days. Now, here comes my review for the game. And let me just say right out that my score for this game is actually pretty high. It's not a perfect 10 out of 10. I don't care if people are going to fucking... rage in the comments. I'm not those type of fools that would just rate a game a 10 out of 10 just because I'm really hyped for it and just because it's the thing now. Alright? And you know what? If you guys have a problem with my score, then you can just suck a dick, okay? Because I know that a woman reviewer, is getting a whole bunch of shit just because she gave this game a 9 out of 10. I'm sorry, but if you're complaining or bitching or trying to get that woman fired for just giving the game a 9 out of 10, you need some mental help and need to back the fuck off, okay? And I'm sorry if any of my subscribers are one of those people. It's just, it really pisses me off when someone gives a very good score for a very good game and they bitch about it. I don't understand that. Anyways, let me just get on with my review. First thing I'm going to touch on is the story for each three characters. Now, from what I've been hearing, a lot of people have been saying this, and I actually agree with them. Michael's story is the best story in this game, because it's completely different from what you're used to in a Grand Theft Auto game. As before, you know, you're pretty much just a criminal, you have no family. Well, in Grand Theft Auto 4, you had Roman, but other than that, you really had no family, you were pretty much on your own, you had friends and all that. But with Michael, you had an actual family, you had a son, daughter, wife. You know, it was completely different from what you expect, and from with how Rockstar handled that, I actually really enjoyed it. I thought showing Michael's more killer side, more psychotic, you know, criminal side, and compare that to his more family, fatherly side, I thought they handled that pretty well. Really, really well, actually. Now, I will say, one thing I kind of wish they did, which I don't think they've ever done this in a Grand Theft Auto game, is show... And I kind of wish they did this with Michael's family, have one of his kids be like more, you know, they don't care about violence, they don't care about drugs, they don't care about sex. You know, just to see how Michael would react, or someone like Michael, how they would react to, say, one of their kids acting like that, where, you know, almost every character in Grand Theft Auto, in every Grand Theft Auto game, they're pretty much dicks. There's no denying that. Most Grand Theft Auto game, pretty much every Grand Theft Auto game, every character is a dick. So that would be pretty interesting to see someone like Michael react to their kid, who pretty much isn't like any other Grand Theft Auto character out there, who is more kind-hearted. I think it would bring some laughs into it. But other than that, I think Michael's story is the best because of that aspect, and I think it had a lot more depth to it, especially since the story pretty much revolved around Michael. Next is Trevor, which, you know, his story revolves around the main story as well, but it also was like, if I had to say how much each story of each character mattered in the main story, it would be Michael's first, then Trevor's, and then Franklin. And by that I mean, like, I have to say Trevor's story was good. You know, I really liked learning more about him. I think, in my honest opinion, it was more of a tragic character compared to every other character in the Grand Theft Auto series. And by tragic, I mean like more his childhood, because, you know, he was explained throughout the game. You know, he had a pretty bad childhood, most likely from an abusive father. I think he mentioned that. He was also discharged from the military because of his psychological issues. And, you know, a lot of the emotion with him and Michael and with the wife from the Hispanic guy, I have to say, I really felt sorry for Trevor. Just the way he felt, especially how he felt betrayed about with Michael on how Ben was actually dead and not alive and in jail. You know, I really felt sorry for the guy. And, you know, listening to conversations with him and what's-her-face, I can't remember her name, mainly because she wasn't in the game that much, but with that, I really felt sorry for him. His have to be my second favorite, where with Franklin, a lot of I've been hearing that some people or a lot of people have been agreeing with me on this. Franklin's story is the weakest, and to be honest, I really don't care for it. I didn't really care for the character of Franklin either. To be honest, I thought CJ was a lot better character. I mean, that's not saying I didn't hate Franklin, I just didn't care much for him. You know, his story didn't much revolve around the main story that much. I mean, he had some missions that involved characters from the main story, but in terms of, like, does he have any involvement in it? Not really. I mean, yes, he is one of the main characters, but I'm talking about, like, where does the story revolve around, which is mainly Michael and Trevor's past, and how Michael's past caught up with him with the FIB, and then Trevor with the Chinese. With Franklin, it was mainly just about Stretch, which really didn't pop up that much, so I really wish they did a little bit more with him. And plus, Franklin, he had some missions on his own, but some of them were side missions, and others were just... I just wish they did a little bit more with Franklin. Now, another thing with the main story, I have to say the main story is good. I do think, though, that it's not the best. I have to say Grand Theft Auto 4 is just a wee bit better in story, mainly because it had a little bit more dark emotion to it, especially with the ending choices. Now, that's not saying the story is bad. I actually really love the story. I think the script is downright well written, and it's probably the best script I've actually in the Grand Theft Auto series. But when it comes to story, I think it needed a little bit more, you know? And I do kind of wish there was a little bit more tragic things to happen. Like, I was hoping Lamar would die, not because I hate him, which I didn't. I actually started to like him a lot more as time progressed. But with that mission, I was actually hoping something bad would happen to Lamar, just to give the game a little bit more emotion. Or when Michael's family was attacked by Devin Weston's men, and I kind of wish someone in his family would die. You know, I really wish something tragic would have happened, but it didn't. So I was a little disappointed in that. Gameplay-wise, I have to say the gameplay is just magnificent. It honestly makes this game the best Rockstar game to date, in my opinion. Because I played a lot of Rockstar games. I haven't played all of them, but all the ones I've played, you know, all the Grand Theft Auto 3, Vice City, San Andreas, 4, this one, Max Payne 1, Max Payne 3, Red Dead Redemption, and Bully. This, honestly, in my opinion, is the best game Rockstar has made. The controls for the cars just felt so smooth and relaxing. You know, back in Grand Theft Auto 4, when you try to turn or drift, the freaking car would just turn all over the place, and it really pissed me off, especially during the races. And I'm so glad controlling a car, and definitely controlling a motorcycle, just felt so natural. Where it just didn't turn as much. It didn't swerve as much. And let me just say, this review is actually so much better than what I did originally. Now, for combat, I have to say, I really like the melee. I think the melee was well done. Gun-wise, I have to say, you know, firing weapons and all that, I think those are actually really, really well done as well. The only problem I have with firing weapons is the cursor to aim. I hate games that have the cursors as a little white dot. I hate that so much because you can't see where the hell you're aiming. Most of the time when I was trying to aim at someone, they would I would be aiming at them, but it turns out the cursor was just pointing a little to the left and I would be missing a whole bunch. So sometimes I didn't even notice where the cursor was. That's why I mainly just kept going in and out on aiming. You know, since the game pretty much auto-aims, which I think that I'm not a big fan of that. I mean, I don't care for auto-aim, and I don't care for free aim, but I kind of wish they gave you... they might have the choice in the options menu, I don't know, I didn't check. But either way, I kind of liked it, but at the same time I didn't. But either way, I think the game was actually pretty hard at some missions. What else? There was also a little option I noticed that said skip if you die too much. I kind of wish they didn't put that. I don't know what it does exactly, but I can pretty much figure out it's saying like skip this one part of the mission, which honestly I think that is stupid to put in there. Another thing, the graphics. I think the graphics looked absolutely beautiful in this game. A lot of people have been complaining when it was first released that the 360 won't be able to... The 360 is actually the worst system to play this game on, because apparently from a streaming, which, you know, it's a streaming, so you can't really judge from a stream, is that the game will have frame rate issues, lag. Well, I don't know about lag. Lag is more multiplayer. I don't know why I said that. Frame rate issues, graphic blop, pop-ins, that kind of stuff. And to be honest, I did not suffer any of that stuff. The frame rate was perfectly fine. Really no issues there. And the graphic pop-ins, I saw maybe two or three of them. I want to say at least 10 of them. But that wasn't until like later in the game, like halfway or the last 20 minutes of it. I'm going to mute that. But yeah, I barely experienced any of those problems with the graphic pop-ins. So yeah, didn't really have any issues. Now, I think that's pretty much all I can really say. I can't really judge the multiplayer yet because I haven't played it yet. I actually am finishing this on September 24th, so the multiplayer hasn't even come out yet. It's coming out October 1st, so I hope you guys enjoyed the multiplayer videos, because obviously this video is not going up until weeks later from when I'm actually beating this. So, yeah. My overall score for this game is a 9.5 out of 10. I just can't get it to a 10 out of 10. I definitely think this is a must-buy. And also, they put a lot of detail in this game. I was very surprised by that. I can't really explain exactly how much detail, because I was just very surprised by how much little things they actually added to make it seem more realistic. My mind was blown by that. One thing I was very surprised by was getting out of the car if it's flipped over, how they actually kick open the door and then you crawl out. Perfect. What was that? Anyways, I give the game a 9.5 out of 10. It's a must buy in my opinion. If you're not a big fan of Grand Theft Auto, of course you're not probably not going to... I feel like I'm hearing something. If you're not a big fan of Grand Theft Auto, of course this game's not going to be for you. But if you know... I say give this game a chance because it was just a fun ride, and yeah, it was a fun ride. I give it a 9.5 out of 10. I hope you guys enjoyed the Let's Play, and I will see you guys next time.